Okay, so addition and subtraction of integers. So in this example, and the examples that follow, I will show you kind of all the different variations that can happen to two numbers, okay, with regards to addition and subtraction, and possibly, you know, utilizing the negative and positives to solve. So this first example, which is an example that typically, if you're going through school, is one which is extremely common. It's the addition of basically two positive numbers. And whenever you do have two positive numbers, you can kind of think of money. You know, when you're going to have $907, and you're going to add another $469, and then, you know, your account is going to grow. So in this example, most students, aside from maybe starting off, they don't really have much issue with this particular case. It's a matter of trying to practice it enough times. Now, when you line these up, make sure that the place values align so that when you are doing this, so your place value of ones, you can add up together and you'll have 7 plus 9. That's going to give you 16. Now, I can only place one digit underneath. So, you know, I'll put the 6. And because the answer was 16, I will carry to the tens the 1. Now again, so the next column that we have, we're going to add up all our tens. Now when you're adding up all your tens, then in this case we're going to come up with 7. So there's nothing to carry because we only have one single digit. And then finally with the last one, so with our last column right here, we're going to add it up and we have 9 plus 4, which is 13. So there is no more digits to follow. So therefore, you're going to just simply put 13. And of course, this is positive because the two numbers were positive. So that's what happens in this case. And this example is not that difficult, but of course it still takes a bit of practice to try to get used to, and do it enough times, you know, you'll get better at it. Now, what else can happen? So the next example that I'll give you, and I'll stick with kind of something which is similar, but in this case, what we have is, so let's say I have negative 907 and I'm going to subtract 469. You know, so the way that I like to kind of envision this, and I mention it all the time, is, well, you're basically in debt, $907. And now you're going to go out and you're going to shop. So you're going to spend more money. Now, if you spend more money, you're going to be more in debt. So with these two particular numbers that we have here, so in reality, what we have is we basically have a growth of our debt. So now, if you don't have a calculator and you're trying to do this, then you're actually going to do exactly the same thing as you did above. Except above, you were adding money because your account was growing. Here, you're going to still be adding, but you're adding up your debt. So in this example, so you have 907, and you're basically going to add the debt of 469 because you went out and you shopped. So both of these are identical. So when you look at them, so we already did this, so we know that the answer is 1,376. However, because it's debt, we have to remember that this is negative. Now, one of the more common errors here is because students are so used to multiplication of two negatives equaling a positive, notice that there is no multiplication. So if you wanted to write this out as a multiplication, you would have to see something like this. So you either will multiply, okay, so you can put this in brackets. Now, utilizing these brackets with the multiplication is a little bit of an overkill, but because it is a negative, okay, so it would be different. So these two things are not the same, okay? Yes, indeed, when you multiply two negatives, you get a positive. But our example here above is basically the addition of debt. So be aware of that. Now, what else can happen here? Okay, so it turns out, okay, so I'm going to kind of make a line here, because in the above two cases that you just saw, we were just adding up. So when our signs are the same, so notice in the first example, 907 and 469, so these were both positive, and we just added up. Okay, and now in the second example, so if you take a look, so these are negatives, okay, so both of them, and again, we were adding up. So when the signs are the same, we can just add. Now, what happens if I scroll down here? So what I'm going to do is next, is now I'm going to subtract. So imagine I have, so still the same. So I have an account and I have $907 and I'm going to go out and spend $469. So with this one, I'm going to put my 907 on top and I'm going to subtract the 469 and that will go at the bottom. And now once again, now except because I am subtracting, so just like in my first case. So look what happens here. Well, I can't subtract 7 minus 9. So I run into a problem. And because 7 is smaller than 9, I would have to go over to the tens. Now, in the tens, right there, I have a 0. So I can't kind of take away or borrow, okay, to create from the 7, I would want to have 17. So what I do now is I basically take away, instead of the 0, I'm going to take away from the 90. So if you're looking at this, so if this is 90 right here, and I take away 1, so 90 minus 1, I'm going to have 89 left. And taking away that 1, the 7 will turn into 17. Now 17 minus 9, now I can do that. Okay, so what is 17 minus 9? It is equal to 8. So now I move over. Let me clean this up a little bit just so that we can see this a little better. So next, what I have is, now I have the 9, right? Remember that that 0 is not there. So I have 9 minus 6, which is equal to 3. And then finally, in the last one, I have 8 minus 4. So again, remember the 9 is gone. So 8 minus 4 is 4. So my answer is 438 when I subtract. And of course, that should make sense to you because you will have money left over in your account if you spend less than your total. So that's a regular subtraction that we have. Now, this case with regards to subtraction can happen in three other cases where we do exactly the same thing. So for instance, you could have had -907 and you were adding 469. So notice what I'm doing here. So here in the first one, this was positive, here is negative. Now this is now negative, now this is positive. So when you're adding and subtracting, and one number is positive, one number is negative, like we have here, then in those cases, we're always going to subtract the bigger number, which is going to be 907, and we're going to subtract the smaller number from it. So that's not actually what it says here, right? If you take a look at this. And you, okay, when you don't have a calculator, you have to understand that the negative 907, so you're in debt. And basically, you are reducing your debt by 469. So it should make sense to you as well. Here is my debt. I'm in debt $907. And here is, I'm going to reduce my debt by 469. So my debt is going to shrink. So that's why I'm subtracting the two numbers. And my answer is going to be 438, because the question is identical in terms of numbers. However, you are still in debt. And this is what I mean, that, you know, you have your debt of $907 and you're reducing that debt by 469. So your debt has shrunk, but it hasn't disappeared. Okay, so that's another case that can happen. Now we can play around with these, and you may also see something, you know, I can now reverse the numbers. Okay, and for instance, I can have 469 and I will subtract 907. So now you have some money in your account, but you actually spend more. And just as I referred to the last two examples, notice that again, you have one positive and one negative. So every time you see that, you're always going to do exactly the same thing. You always take the bigger number. In this case, it's 907. And then you're going to take away the smaller number. Now, again, we did this already. I'm sorry here. So let me just update this, because this is 469. Okay, so, and as I mentioned, so we did this, so our answer is 438. But now the question, is it positive or is it negative? Well, you only had 469 in your account. So, well, you spent more than you had. So you actually went into debt. So this is going to be negative. Okay, so that's what you have there. And now the last case that can happen. Okay, so I'm just basically showing you what can happen with these. Now this, you can be in debt, and now you're going to pay off your debt. Okay, and you're going to have some money left over. So with this particular case, the setup again is the same. So you're going to subtract. Okay, and our answer, since we did this already. However, now the question is it positive or negative? Well, you're in debt 469. Okay, and you pay off basically your entire debt, and you will be in the positive because you put in to your account more money, okay, than you were in debt. Okay, so this answer is actually positive. And when you're looking at the signs, again, notice. So notice the trend here that we have. Okay, so for all of these examples that I just did, okay, so for this one, number three, number 4, number 5, and number 6. I've rearranged the numbers, but all of them are a case of subtraction. Because, okay, you have one number which is positive and then negative. Okay, so if you're looking at this, it's kind of how you can think about it, especially when you don't have calculators. And when that happens, you always take the bigger number and you place the bigger number on top and you place the smaller number at the bottom and you simply subtract and ask yourself, is the answer positive or is it negative? Okay, so that's what we have there. Now, let me do kind of one more example with these additions and subtractions. Okay, so for you. So now, something which might be a little bit bigger. Okay, so for instance, let's take a look. Okay, so let's say we do a straight subtraction. Let's say 13,011, and I will subtract, let's say 6,299, because I just want to show you again the borrowing concept. So in this case, as I'm subtracting, well, 1 minus 9 won't work. But now, however, I have a 1 here. Now, because I have a 1, I will borrow or take away that 1. So that instead of 1 having here, this is going to be 11. And now, because I took away, okay, so I took away the 1, okay, this is going to turn into a 0. So now 11 minus 9 is equal to 2. Okay, so that's what we have. Now, what do we still have left over? Okay, so now next, okay, so what we have is, let me move that. So now, so I have this 0 here. And 0 minus 9, well, that's not going to work. So what do I do? Well, I know that I'm going to have to take away from the next number, but I can't because it's a 0. So I have to, instead of taking away from the 0, I'm going to take away here from the 30. So this, if you take away 1 from 30, it becomes 29. Okay, and this will become 10. So now 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. And now I can continue, and I have 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. And now finally, so the last one, so I have 2 minus 6. Well, I can't do that because 6 is bigger. So I'm going to take away the 1 here. Okay. Now, if I take away the 1, it turns into a 0, so I have nothing left there. And then the 2 here is going to now be 12. And now 12 minus 6 is equal to 6. And that would be your final answer. And I encourage you to try this on your own. So, you know, pause the video, go back or rewind it and try it, okay, so that you can see how to do it. Okay, thank you for watching.